Hi students, today our topic is input and output functions in C. We know that the program is a set of instructions specifically written to perform a specific task. One designed task, if you want to perform, means we'll write a set of instructions that is called as a program. Right, in order to write a program, we need to get the inputs. That is like from the user side, we need to get the inputs. And according to the logic and according to the implementation procedure, we need to write the codings. So that coding parts are considered as process here. After processing, that result should be displayed on some other output devices. It may be in a screen, or it may be it should be printed in some format like that. So that result output after the logic, the results will come out. No, that results are considered as output. So this is the flow of our down logic. First, we need to process about inputs, and then we need to write the logic. Then after that, we need to concentrate about the output. So this is the flow of our logic. I have taken the example for mark sheet of your student. That means that we need to get the marks individual wise, subject wise, we need to get the marks. So after getting the marks, we need to do some processing, finding the total and average and CGPA and whether that marks is graded like a pass or fail. So this and all has to be done as like a process. After processing, that desired output should be displayed in a screen or some other PDF format or some other outputted format. So this is my logic. So reading a data from the input devices is called as input processing, and after processing our logic, that the result, displaying the results in the output devices is another one task. So these are the two main tasks in any given program. Okay, first we need to get the some inputs, and after processing we need to display some results. So this is the main two tasks in any given program, any given logic or any given solution. So that is what we are going to see it in our video. Right, input and output functions act as a link between user and terminal. Yeah, obviously, because we need to get the values from users and we need to display the outputs in a screen. So getting a input from the keyboard is called as a standard input functions. So reading a value from a keyboard is called as a standard input functions. What are the examples of standard input functions are? Scanf, getchar, getch, getus, and etc. So each is having a special logic behind it. Scanf will be used for some reading of values, and getchar is only used for reading a single character, and getch is same like that, and getus is to read a single line from the terminal, from the keyboard. So this is, each is having separate logic behind it. Similarly, displaying the result on a screen is called as a standard output function. What are those famous standard output functions? That means printf, putchar, putch, and puts. So let us see in detail one by one. So before that, we need to that input and output functions are classified into two types. Before going to see each functions, input and output functions, these functions are classified into two types. What are those types? Means first one is formatted function, another one is unformatted functions. Formatted functions, examples of formatted functions are scanf and printf. Why it is called as scanf and printf? Means scan in formatted way, print in formatted way. Okay, so we need to get the values, we need to read one value, that value should be in some defined format. Say for example, I want to read the value 100, means 100, that value, I need to read that value in a floating point. Means what will happen, 100.00 will be scanned as a formatted input. Say for example, I want to print the values of 25,000.0257 like that. Means that value, that I want to print that value, that decimal fractional value, up to only two fractional, 0.2 only. So if I want to print my floating point value in some only allowed decimal points, means I can use printf here. So that is what it is called as reading a value in a formatted way, displaying the results in some formatted way. That is what it is abbreviated like scanf and printf. Then what about get care, put care and get as put as means? So these are coming under unformatted functions. Like if I want to read one character means, I can simply use get care function. There is no need to specify the format specifier, percentage C and control specification, and there is no rule in that. Just you can use get care function, and that that character which I brought from user is will be stored in some character variable. Simple one, only one state, it reduces the size complexity of your program. So get care, if I use get care function, means it will simply read the one character from the terminal. That variable, that character will be stored in character variable. Similarly, if I want to display one character in the screen, means I can use put care. So those are called as unformatted functions. Okay, so formatted functions are nothing but in order to read the values and to display the values in defined, in some user defined format, means I can use scanf and printf, or else simply I want to use my reading a character, reading a line and reading a string, means I can use unformatted functions. Both are valid way of using C program, by valid way of writing C programs. Right, let us see one by one. Formatted input means I have taken some examples here. So 50, 13.45 and RAM. So here 50 is considered as integer. 13.45 is considered as float. And RAM, RAM, is considered as character variables, right? So this is possible using scanf. How using scanf statement means, because scanf has general format. It follows some general format to read your formatted inputs. So what is the format we are following here means, scanf, there is no space between scan and f. So it is a single word, scanf, it is a keyword. So scanf, then we have to open a double quotation, the control string should be used. Okay, the control string, then we have to close the quotation, double quotation, then comma, arguments list. So those are called as argument list. You can use n number of arguments here. That means that you can read n number of variables using a single scanf statement. Okay, but we need to use the control string in a correct way. How many arguments you are going to read, then exact control string should be followed in the first part. Okay, so that is what the scanf statement consists of, two parts. First part is a control string part, second one is a argument list part. Okay, so what is meant by control string? What it will be having means, control strings are nothing but it consists of format identifiers. Say for example, I am going to read one integer, means to read my integer, I am following one format identifier, that is percentage I. If I want to, sorry, percentage D, sorry, sorry, percentage D. So if I want to read one floating point, means I should use percentage F. And if I want to read one character, means percentage C. So like that, this format find format specifiers are there. So those format specifiers should be included in control string. So that is what it is having, a formatted reading of your values. Okay. Then what is meant by argument list? Arguments are like variables list. How many variables are you are going to use? So this argument list should be preceded by the ampersand symbol. Okay. So in this control string, let us see control string. So that control strings are having format identifiers. So what are the conversion characters, format identifier we are having here means, I have given one table along with the examples. If we take character reading, means percentage C is a format identifier. So how we can use printf percentage C, A. A is my one value. That value will be printed. Then decimal integer. That is nothing but whole number, integer. So percentage D is used. That percentage D, 100 is my value, that is printed. And if I want to display hexadecimal integer, means percentage X is this format specifier. So for that I can use for percentage X, 100. And octal integer representation is also available in C. So that will be displayed using percentage O, So print using printf statement percentage %O, 100, and unsigned decimal. Unsigned decimal will be used by percentage %U. That is like unsigned means it doesn't have any signed rotation, minus or plus. And similarly, floating point number will be used by the format specifier percentage %F. And F, that means if you want to specify the percentage with E format, means you can use percentage %G symbol. And then if you want to print or scan my one entire string, means I can use percentage %S. So these are the different format specifier which are used in printf statement and scanf statement. What is the use of format specifier? Means it only tells that the nature of that value. Percentage %C means it is a character type, and percentage %D means it is a integer type, and percentage %X means it is a hexadecimal, percentage %S means it is a string, that the value which is going to read or which is going to display on the screen will be in the type of string. That means that it only tells the compiler that the nature of that variable, nature of that value. Okay. I hope you understand this logic. I'll catch you in the next video about next topic.